Tavis. What are you doing?
Sergeant, I thought my orders were very clear. You aren't supposed to be here.
I will take him.
No, Wraith. The Sergeant deserves to know the truth. I had hoped it wouldn't come to this. I harbor no ill will toward you. You're everything a warrior should be. But I'm afraid the Republic no longer values her warriors, even the very best among them.
You fought the Empire for years. Do you really think things are better over there?
The Empire respects warriors, Sergeant. The Republic's top officials, on the other hand, have decided to cast us aside. The truth is that no matter what they may say, the Republic Senate doesn't actually believe it can win another war against the Empire. That makes you and I a threat. Every Havoc Squad victory fires up people's imaginations. It fills them with pride, which means the bureaucrats can't afford to let us keep succeeding.
You've really lost it. What you're saying, it's absurd.
If only you'd been with us longer, Sergeant, you would understand. You might even have come with us. The Republic abandoned us. During a mission on Ando Prime, they simply left us to die. But I won't try to persuade you. Honestly, I hope you die with your ideals intact. The rest of us will never have that luxury.
It's not too late, Tavis. You can still turn back.
Turn back to what? The Republic that wants me dead and gone? No, Sergeant, I think not.
Oh, by the way, good work finding the ZR-57 for us. We were starting to worry that the Separatists might, you know, waste our big present for the Empire.
But thanks to you, we can now present the Empire with this magnificent tool of destruction.
Glad I could contribute to your treason.
We'd better get a move on, boss. If we don't break Atmo in the next few minutes, every gun in the sky will have a clear shot on us.
Time we were off. Colonel Vore, please give the sergeant the warrior's death he deserves.
Eventually.
It's been an honor serving with you, Sergeant. Goodbye.
Our pirate friend had a little accident trying to escape the Separatist's base. Our pal Phipps' face turned purple when he heard the news. Brilliant. Brilliant work there.
He was clearly trouble, regardless of what he knew.
Well, he's no trouble now, thanks to you. Here's your reward. Consider it fair compensation for your service to the Republic. And remember, this is our little secret.
Anything a soldier needs, some things he doesn't. Good luck out there.
Word is, you secured the landing area. Good work. War's never pretty, but I want you to know you're a real hero. It's important to remember we're fighting for peace on Ord Mantell.
I'm just doing my duty, Captain.
You're a proud example of Havoc Squad and the Republic military. Thank you for your efforts. Hopefully this fight's almost done.
General, with all due respect, how can you do this? I've served with you in infantry command for years.
That's enough, Jorgan. This wasn't my choice. But a defection of this scale, somebody has to swing, and the powers that be say it's you.
What's going on here?
Your command full of traitors just destroyed my career, Sergeant. Command can't punish them, so they're burning me instead.
You must be our last loyal Havoc member. I'm General Vander, Republic Chief of Operations for Ord Mantell. It's a pleasure to finally meet you. On behalf of the Republic and the people of Ord Mantell, I want to thank and congratulate you for your courageous actions in disabling the stolen ZR-57. Your heroic efforts saved countless innocent lives. In recognition of your valiant service, I hereby promote you to the rank of Lieutenant. Congratulations.
I'm honored.
Now, Lieutenant, as the last remaining member of Havoc, the duty of rebuilding the squad falls to you. Havoc is your command. To get the process started, I've decided to assign Sergeant Jorgan here as Havoc's first new member.
I'd be glad to have you in the unit, Jorgan.
I'll take the Havoc patch and Sergeant Stripes if it means I get to grind them into Tavis's face before we kill him.
This is the best I can do for you, Jorgan. You're a good man. We need good people now more than ever. I don't know what Tavis is planning, but he knows the inner workings of our military better than anyone. The destruction he could cause is limitless.
I won't allow Tavis and the others to harm the Republic, sir.
Just don't underestimate them, Lieutenant. Tavis and his followers won't be easy to take down. In any case, your work here is done. I've got a shuttle prepped and you're going to Coruscant for your next assignment. When you arrive on Coruscant, report immediately to the head of Spec Force Division, General Garza. She'll be issuing your orders from now on.
Understood, sir.
You'd better get to your shuttle. It's waiting for you in the landing bay. Lieutenant, Sergeant, you're dismissed. I hope I see you again someday.
Helping Adam.
I need to talk to you. In private. So, Havoc Squad. The best of the best. Can't say I'm thrilled about the demotion, but it's an honor to be here, sir.
I realize the circumstances weren't ideal, but I'm glad you're with us, Jorgan.
A spot in Havoc was the least they could do. 4 years at the Academy, 7 years in the field, decorations, commendations. Would have made captain soon if command hadn't hung me out to dry.
We both know Tavis's defection wasn't your fault.
Tell that to the brass when they need a scapegoat. But hey, water under the bridge. Command put me in Havoc to help you find Tavis, and I intend to do just that. I've hunted Imperials from one side of the galaxy to the next. Used to command the Deadeyes, finest sniper squad in the Republic.
I look forward to seeing what you can do, Jorgan.
You won't be disappointed.
On your feet.